Welcome to Theme Thursday on Food Talk with Shirin. The theme for this month is crepes, and today's recipe is apple and cinnamon crepes. Now, apple and cinnamon pair perfectly well, and you drizzle these crepes with some chocolate sauce or caramel sauce, and you've got a perfect breakfast. So, without further delay, let's quickly check out the ingredients for this. But before that, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Food Talk with Shirin. So let's first prepare the batter for these crepes. Now for this, I've taken two apples and I've cut this into chunks like this. Now if you want, you can slice it thin and use it or leave it like this. I like to have that little bite in my filling. I'm also leaving the skin on, but if you don't prefer that, you can actually remove the skin and then chop it up. Into the chopped apples, let's first add in some lemon juice. Next, goes in some sugar. It's an apple cinnamon crepe, so of course some cinnamon powder. Let's toss the apple so that it's all coated in the cinnamon and sugar mixture. Now our pan is hot, let's add some butter and then the cinnamon and sugar coated apples and cook it for about 5 minutes. So cook this on medium heat. You'll see the sugar melting and a nice syrup forming. So in case you're using green apples, you can skip the lemon because green apples in general have a tangy taste. The apples are done now. You can see a caramelized coating on top of the apples, and I prefer to leave it a little crunchy. I don't like the apples cooked through, so I'm taking it off from heat now. Now that the filling for the crepe is ready, let's prepare the batter. For this, I'm taking 2 eggs. Let's first whisk this gently. Into this, I'm adding milk, melted butter, vanilla essence, sugar, and some salt. Let's whisk this again once before we add in the flour. Next goes in 1 cup of flour. Use a whisk or a fork so that all the lumps in the batter are broken down and you've got a fine flowy batter. You can always add in some additional water to make sure you have a batter which is of spreadable consistency. This batter now is of a good pourable consistency, so I'm not adding any further water to it. But in case you feel you need it a little more liquidy, you can always add a tiny bit of water. Heat your pan for making the crepes and keep it on medium heat. And spread the crepe batter evenly and thin all around.